I'm a professor in the Department of Physics, is where the engineering physics degree program resides. And so I'd just like to give you a sense of sort of the department, the opportunities for students, and the degree plan. And then honestly, open it up to questions, because I think that's the most useful bit of this whole process. So first of all, just to give you an idea of the Department of Physics, where engineering physics resides, it's a very large department. So we have basically the third largest number of undergraduate majors. There are two majors, physics and engineering physics, within the program, as well as a large PhD program and a lot of faculty. And that'll give students a lot of opportunities that we'll talk about later in terms of getting involved in real world applications. We're sort of a well-known department. Every year we're rated top in molecular, atomic, and optical physics, which is great because we always usually beat MIT, which is always this competition between the two of us. And so we're overall a top 10 physics department in the country. And really importantly with engineering physics major is we're very interdisciplinary. So you'll see a little bit about how engineering physics really combines the applied side of engineering with the more fundamental side of physics and a unique degree. So just to tell you that, you know, we have a lot of folks who have done some major things. We have four Nobel laureates, and these folks teach classes. Eric Cornell is teaching the introductory lab course that all engineering and science majors teach right now. So you really get to interact with a lot of really inspiring folks. In addition, we have three MacArthur Fellows. You ever heard these genius grants? We have three folks who have won that. In fact, we have all the women there for a while who won it in physics right in our own department. So there are a lot of awesome faculty that you get to interact with in courses and through undergraduate research. Additionally, besides the research aspect that you get to involved with as an undergrad, we take teaching very seriously at the University of Colorado. We have two folks have won U.S. Professor of the Year. This is not in physics. This is not local to CU, but actually any professor throughout the entire United States. And both of these folks teach courses at the University of Colorado. So we take teaching very seriously, and students often come here because of the excellent education that really goes well beyond a traditional lecture and really gets students to think interactively. Also importantly, our students are award winners. They really thrive in this environment. This is just an example from a few years ago. There's something called the Goldwater Scholar, which is awarded to about 250 students throughout the entire U.S. We had four of them right here win Goldwater Scholarships, which is a large financial sum and also quite a large honor. Additionally, every semester there are the Engineering College Outstanding Graduates. So we have one of the smallest programs in the College of Engineering, and yet by far we win the Outstanding Graduate in Research and overall at a higher rate than anybody else. Our students really get the opportunity to distinguish themselves, and this is just a selection from the last couple of years of folks have won those awards. So it's an outstanding department, and part of it is the sort of degree program that we have sketched out for students. I would say engineering physics is probably the most flexible engineering degree. Other engineering degrees have very little flexibility, but this one has a lot. And so in general, there's a core of physics courses. So those are 54 credits. And those are the same courses an arts and science major would take. But then to get into the engineering electives, there are 20 credits in engineering. And this is broad. Anything from the College of Engineering, any technical elective, you can take. And so this is where the flexibility comes in. Some folks are really interested in, say, in aerospace. So they take all of their electives in aerospace. Others take an applied math, computer science, electrical. Others want a little bit more of a broad background and will take a few classes in sort of one major and another to sort of build their sort of engineering elective types of classes. So that's really where flexibility comes in. Typical for every College of Engineering degree, there's math, chemistry, computer science, and humanities. And those sort of are pretty general to the College of Engineering generally. But it's really those engineering electives that you can tailor the degree to, and students have done all sorts of things with that. So if we dig into a little bit about the physics coursework, this is a relatively standard type of program where we have general physics, right, intro physics, classical mechanics, electricity and magnetism, quantum, which now includes a quantum computing course as a possible elective, thermodynamics. Then we really focus a lot on the hands-on component. And so there's a couple of introductory experimental physics courses. The course that I think is the most fun in the entire major is an electronics lab where you get to design and build both digital and analog electronics. And this is capped off by a five-week student project where students choose what they want to do. And there's all sorts of exciting things that come in there from, you know, laser microphones to haptic sensors for magnetic fields, a lot of guitar pedals. That turns out to be a very popular one. Students building their own guitar pedals. So that's a really fun hands-on introduction to electronics. That's very practical. Students can really walk out of there being able to do things. In addition to all of this, there are three upper division physics electives that you can take maybe in quantum information or particle physics or condensed matter physics, depending on what you're interested in. And that asterisk there is because one of those we focus on sort of a lab and research experience. So one of the things that distinguishes our engineering physics program as in addition to the engineering degree is our focus on getting students into actual authentic research experiences. So I just want to give you a little sense of that. So there's sort of a broad range of active research topics and that all of these have undergraduate students actively participating in a really vital way. So there's atomic, molecular, and optical physics, which we're well known for, but there's a large range of different types of physics programs. In fact, almost any type of physics that you would like to do, we have represented at the University of Colorado, from biophysics to high energy physics, elementary particle, plasma, solid state, almost everything you can think of. And so just give you a little sense of some of the topics that our students have been engaged in research over the last couple of years. In the upper left-hand corner, you can see actually myself and an undergraduate student working on a pulse dye laser to trap and cool molecules to near absolute zero. There's on the upper right-hand corner, you can see a lab that looks at high-temperature superconductors and how those can be made more realistic. There's also sort of the big particle experiments. So down in the lower left-hand corner is the relativistic heavy ion collider. So students work on these projects both remotely and able to go to these large colliders and collect data and have shifts. There's sort of a large range of possible projects. You can see others here where we have the best clock in the world at the bottom left-hand corner, the strontium atomic clock that has the best timekeeping of any clock in the world, as well as more applied things where we have femtosecond X-ray lasers, where they're building commercial products of new lasers. So all of these experiments have undergraduates readily involved in this research. And how does one get involved in research is often the question. Well, we have a couple of opportunities to learn more about this. So in the fall, we have something called the Undergraduate Research Info Symposium. So this is an opportunity to learn from faculty and most importantly, other students about how to get involved in research. What is it like? What kind of things are you going to be doing? And what sort of things do you gain from this experience? So that happens in the fall. So you're able to use that information to search for positions. And then in the spring, there's a great opportunity to show off the research that's been conducted over the last year. So there's undergraduate research poster session where students create a poster of their research and then everybody walks around and gets to learn about the research going on in the department at the undergraduate level. And so those are great experiences that we're able to do partly because we have such a strong research program. So I'd like to really focus on this idea that physics is a hands-on science. You know, for a lot of engineering, it's much more on the computer, but for us, we really want students to have practical skills. So all of our students are offered a free machine shop course and welding course, so you can get in there and actually build components with mills and lathes and weld together components. And this is both to create parts for research, but also, you know, like I say, fix your bike or design your own projects, and that's available to all of our students. So we really want to focus on building and doing hands-on type of science. So thinking a little bit more about what you can do with all of these skills, they're really sort of a large range of career opportunities. I always say the sort of best and the worst thing I can tell you about the degree is sort of the same thing. Students want to know, so what are my opportunities after I leave CU? And the answer is, I don't know. Because our students go to such a large range of type of careers, it's hard to say what you'd like to do. On the other hand, that means you're sort of skilled and have the problem-solving skills to really tackle whatever career path you're interested in. These are just some of the alumni career paths from the last few years. As you can see, they're quite ranging. And so it's our engineering physics don't go into one particular area, but they do go into a large number. I mean, there are a lot, of course, in the local area, it's our Ball Aerospace and things like that, but there's not one employer that employs all of our students. It's really a large range. Some of our most famous alumni I have to tell you about, of course. One is an astronaut. So Steve Swanson got his engineering physics degree, and you can see him there in the background. I think that's really fun. He comes around to the apartment once in a while to meet with everybody. So maybe a more traditional career path as an astronaut. On the other end, our second most probably well-known graduate is Jose Rosenberg, right? He was top chef. This was a few years ago. He got his engineering physics degree and went on to be a top chef. And in fact, he opened a restaurant, Black Belly Grill. I can't remember the name now, but in Boulder. So there's kind of a large range of type opportunities for engineering physics because we really allow students to gain the skills to solve problems in a range of different careers. So I can't tell you what degree you'll have, what career path you'll have, but the good thing is you really get to choose your career path. So now I'm just going to sort of open it up to questions about engineering physics. Thanks.